The question gives the concentration of hydrogen ion as 5.2 times 10 to the negative 4 molar, and it wants us to find three things, which is pH, pOH, and the concentration of OH minus. I've posted a video explaining the six formulas for pH calculations. We'll be using a few of them here. Now, since we have the concentration of H+, we can use this formula and we'll be able to find the value for pH. Alternatively, we can also start with this formula and then we can find the concentration of OH-. It doesn't matter which formula we start with since we need to find both values anyway, so I'll just use the first formula. The first formula is pH is equals to negative log of H+. We plug in the value of H+, punch in the calculator, negative log of 5.2 times 10 to the negative 4, and we get 3.28 for pH. Now from this calculated pH, we can then easily find the pOH. We use this relationship formula where pH plus pOH is equals to 14. Plug in the value for pH, subtract them, and we get 10.72. Now that we've found the value for pOH, we can use that and we can find the concentration of OH minus. So we find the antilog of negative 10.72 and we get 1.9 times 10 to the negative 11 molar. It's important not to forget the unit for concentration, that's capital M. Now this is one way to find the concentration of OH minus from pOH. Another way is from concentration of H+ directly using this relationship equation. We plug in the given H+ concentration, so we divide the numbers and that gives us 1.9 times 10 to the negative 11 molar. It's the same value as the one we found using the first method. In fact, it should be because we are calculating the same concentration of hydroxide ion. To recap, here's the strategy we use to calculate the values for pH, pOH, and concentration of OH-. We started with the given concentration of H+, and we found the value of pH. From the value of pH, we look for pOH, which we then use to find the concentration of hydroxide ion, OH-. We can also find the concentration of that hydroxide ion directly from H+, if we wish. Now, this is not the only way to find what we need. There are other ways, and in fact, there's no right or wrong sequence as long as it brings you from your starting point to your destination. You may not need to find all three values, but this is just an example to show you how these calculations are interrelated. I hope you find the video helpful. Do subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.